In the last couple of videos, we've developed a technique for figuring out areas of region in the plane. So, if somebody gives us a region in the plane, typically it's the area between a couple of curves, but it could be any region in the plane. Our technique is to take it and break it up into a whole bunch of vertical slices. And then we say that the area of each slice is approximately its height times its width. And of course, the height is a function of x. The height over here is small. The height over here is much bigger. The height over here is small again. So the height is a function of x. Then we add up all the slices and we take a limit and we get an integral. So we always get the idea is that our area is always the integral from what value of x? Well, from this value of x, from whatever the smallest value of x that appears in your region to this value of x. Okay, so this is going to be a, and this is going to be b. So we call this a and this b. You can think b for biggest. And then you integrate whatever the height is times dx. And the height is going to be, you know, if it's a, typically it's a higher curve minus the lower curve. Now I want to show you a different technique for evaluating the area of the same region. And that's to put things through our Vegematic sideways. Instead of cutting things into vertical slices, let's cut them into horizontal slices. And we say, well, what's the area of each slice? Well, the area of each slice is going to be its width, which depends on y. Over here, the width is 0, and then it grows, and then it shrinks again, times the thickness. And the thickness is delta y. And then if we put all of these together, we get a sum of width of y times delta y. And when you take a limit, that sum becomes an integral. So instead of integrating from the smallest value of x to the biggest value of x, you integrate from the smallest value of y to the biggest value of y, you know, from a to b, of not the height, but the width. Either method works. Sometimes it's better to slice vertically. Sometimes it's better to slice horizontally. So for example, let's suppose we want to find the area between the curve y equals square root of x, the y-axis, and y equals 2. Now, no matter how you do it, we're going to have to figure out where these curves intersect, because we're told the left boundary, and you're told the top boundary, but you're not told the bottom value, the right value. So we have to figure out where we're meeting here, and of course, if the square root of x is 2, then x must be 4. So this is the point 4, 2. So if we slice vertically, then we say the height at any point is going to be 2 minus the square root of x. We integrate that. So we have to integrate from the smallest value of x to the biggest value of x, 2 minus root x dx. Now that's a little bit annoying because we don't like having fractional powers of x, but we can handle it. It turns out that, you know, the antiderivative of 2 is 2x, the antiderivative of x to the 1 half is 2 thirds x to the 3 halves, you plug in 4 and 0, and you get an answer, which is 8 thirds. There is an easier way. There's a way that gives you an easier integral. If instead of slicing vertically, we slice horizontally, we have to say, hey, at each height y, what's the width? What is the value of x that corresponds to this value of y? Well, instead of writing this curve as y equals square root of x, we can write it as x equals y squared. So if this is value is y, then this is y squared. And so the width is y squared minus 0. And that's y squared. The height is delta y. The area of, we add all the slices together, and that becomes an integral, the integral of y squared dy. And not only is that an integral, that's a darn easy integral. That just gives you y cubed over 3 evaluated at 0 and at 2, and that's 8 thirds. Now, of course, the answer is the same no matter which way you slice it. The area of the thing is 8 thirds. You can get that as a sum of vertical slices. You can get that as a sum of horizontal slices. It's the same 8 thirds. Now, here's another example. Let's suppose we want the area between the curve y equals natural log of x, y equals 1, and x equals 1. If you try to slice this vertically, well, we know how to do that. We say the area is the top function, that's 1, minus the bottom function, that's natural log of x. So we have to integrate 1 minus natural log of x dx from 1 to e. Trouble is, at this stage of the game, we don't know how to do that integral. What's a function whose derivative is natural log of x? It's not x natural log of x. It's not natural log of x squared over 2. Now, eventually, we'll learn how to do the integrals like this. You know, a technique called integration by parts will take care of this. But at this stage of the game, it's a hard integral. On the other hand, if you write it, if you slice horizontally, it becomes an easy integral. Instead of writing y equals natural log of x, write it as x equals e to the y. So for any given value of y, the minimum value of x is x equals 1, the top value of x is e to the y, the width of the strip is e to the y minus 1. So our area is the integral of the width dy. So that's the integral of e to the y minus 1 dy, and that's just e to the y minus y, evaluated at 1 and at 0, and that gives you e minus 2. So if you slice horizontally, you get an easy integral. If you slice vertically, you get an integral that you don't know how to do. In general, there isn't a simple rule of thumb for when you want to slice vertically and when you want to slice horizontally. Try it each way. If you can slice vertically and get something that you can solve, great. If not, try slicing horizontally. There's some problems where one way is easier. There's some problems where the other way is easier. The important thing to remember is the slice and dice principle. If you can get something by writing it as a sum of little pieces that you can understand, you can get the thing as an integral, and you win.